But we could talk to a team again. So we go for high risk. We'll go medium. Bruh. The last time I went medium or something, I got apps. They kicked me way off. And now I get medium, all of a sudden they're like, wait, we actually want you. Okay. Do that. We do this. And that is all we're gonna be doing for now. One of one for everything. Phew. Oh my god. So I get okay. This is a good thing. A car is not destroyed since we got a new car. Thank God. I thought a car might have to be bashed up for the last time. Okay, so we now have a chance to not break up a car or anything of the sort.
Okay.
Lovely.
We've had the new parts come through the fabrication process. We'll have them with us for the next Grand Prix.
Lovely. Okay, somewhat sensitive, but I guess it was. As we now actually limit to go on to the race weekend. Was it Lewis? God, okay. I have high expressions for you. These sessions, so give it everything you got, in particular, this blow of clarify from Lewis being here. Yes, thank you, Emma. Hi, Mark. Bye, Mark. As we now get on into qualifying here. I'm like to myself, I wonder if I put the mods difficulty and I left them hard still. That could be an issue. That could very much be an issue here, as they're still left on the hard mods. As I'm pacing myself around, like, oh wait a minute, did I leave them on hard mods? Yikers. Actual yikers. We'll see what happens. We'll see. Yeah, if it's hard bots, yeah. We'll give them something for their money. Cause I won't ever change it. Especially when I do things like that. Isn't the best thing I should be doing now, is it? Not in the slightest. I would exceed the track limits, all by accident, too. Lovely. Absolutely lovely. We secured pole position on the starting grid. The competition is fierce, but we're ready to forward the race day challenge.
And with qualifying complete, let's review top three today. Ace, Hamilton, and Lando Norris. Goodbye for now then, but really we're just getting started. Make make sure to join us again for Lights Out tomorrow.
I don't know why I chose the name Ace for them to actually say Ace, but oh well. Next time I should probably see if they have hamburger and they can just say hamburger. But now I shall catch you guys on Into the Race. Often really go here in back queue now. I got a great jump start. Every car's behind me so far. Let's see with this corner here if I don't get absolutely smacked through that day like I did one time. Like I did one time. Get a Mercedes 1-2. It's not impossible. That's for sure. From the racing manual, it doesn't have to be cuts there. Okay. Everything is going too well. Too well for now. I don't know why. Because I thought to myself, did I leave a hard box? I don't remember changing anything.
DRS is being enabled this lap. You can use DRS when you're within 1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone.
Okay. Well, the teammate can end up using it, potentially. So we'll get more of a bigger gap on him potentially, so we won't have to use it on him. to me that it might be me. I really thought my mic was not muted. Just pulled it out. Yeah, found where it was. That's fun. That was fun.
Okay, no issues with the tire wear for now. Keep taking care of it.
You can go in the pits. And I'll just take back my first place. There, okay. Sounds good. Go car. Go faster car. Ooh, got him. Got him. Got him. Got him. What I tell ya. Right, he's gonna go in this, but...
Okay, Lewis is in for his stop.
Yes. I can definitely feel my tires absolutely getting done dusted. But we're gonna push a bit further on this lap, you know? So that then by the time I go in the pit, which will be soon, which will be this lap, as you say, I have a great advantage on everyone else, you know? Because these wheels are very much going and going on. So.
The car behind you's just come in for the hard tires. Car behind, running hard tires.
Copy, copy, copy. Where's Hamilton? I don't see him in the top five. What happened? But the pit stop not that good? It's my question, at least. But, you know, if I'm about to go in here, it's gonna take a hot minute. There's a potential chance for them to catch up, but also is there a chance for them to catch up? I don't know.
Perfect job from you and the crew there, mate. We're delighted with that.
Good to know, good to know. Surely they can't catch me up. Surely.
Up to speed now, let's get some heat into those tires.
Okay. They were far behind me, but now they're like 4 seconds. Yeah, I don't know what to say about that. I thought the pit stop would be fast. Sturdier than that. Still have to say. Oh well. Oh well. Oh well. Modern said, guys, I thought it was just a little vacuum trap. Some turns recently, but then I came to realize this soon. This is great. Honestly, I know this is a pro rifle picture thing. So, you definitely saw the meme market, but knowing me, I wasn't really paying attention to it that much. Sometimes you pay attention, sometimes you don't, but you always pay attention in your class. God knows why I'm trying to give advice to people. I don't know myself. It's only my eyesight. As we are now on to the 10th lap of the race here, you got a great distance between yourself and Mr. George, you know, I can see them right behind me there on the map, but still, it's a reasonable gap between us and them. Sure. So, they won't be able to overtake us like Sainz and Hamilton did before, where my microphone was muted. Gives us a chance to push the car to
gap to your teammate behind is 6.5 seconds.
There he goes. He's in the heart of it. Ben Williams at 1 second. Well, they are behind me, but I expect him to be this close behind me. You know what I'm saying? Give us a chance to push the car at top speed before hitting the brakes for turn and you know. That's completely gonna be fine because my car sliding off right there. That wouldn't happen good. So if you only get DRS on the third lap and that's it. Or is it on this lap too? If I'm pressing it, and nothing's happening. So I just guess on the third lap only. That's kinda strange. Especially when there's more than one DRS lounge here too. Quite strange, you could ask me. Oh well. and get a first place away. You've been hot on my tail for the past few laps now, ever since he overtake Russell. He's getting more and more closer to me. Very much more and more closer to me. Well, that doesn't matter. As long as the car tire or thing is for his, we're fine. Since our engine just keep going, but who cares? As we see, and there you have it. Crossing the finish line in Baku is always special. The adrenaline, the challenges, and the victory. It's what makes F1 racing unforgettable. Call time dark driver day. Smooth.
That's it for another Grand Prix and a fantastic win for Mercedes. What do you think it was today, Ant, that gave them the edge over the competition?
I really feel the track layout combined with the track temperatures we saw today suited their car. These cars come alive when the tires are just at the right temperature, and the driver did a great job managing that as well. They just look so comfortable out there. It's like anything, it always looks so easy when it all just clicks.
I surely got a nice screenshot there.
I can see the drivers starting to approach the podium for the victory celebrations. A real team victory today. Everybody played their part. Congratulations then to Mercedes, your race winners.
Why, thank you, sir. This that trophy looks well, nice. I was broken at the place right there, golly.
So let's review the updated driver standings. Some amazing talent out on the track today, but Anthony, who would you pick as your driver of the day?
Carlos Sainz certainly wasn't someone to scoff about. His ability to follow race strategies throughout with pinpoint precision has to be commended.
It's time to see how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. Mercedes move to the top of the table.
Yes, sir.
Well, what an end to another fantastic weekend of racing. Thanks to everyone who joined us, and we'll see you for the next one.
Deuces.